Okay, hi students. Let's look at the second learning objective, how to calculate quantity using percentage. So an example of such concepts, let's look at workbook page 2, question 5. Okay, so for question 5, right, let's look at 5B. So 5B asks us to calculate the value for 140% of 9.2 kg. So how do I find? So I know that 100% it's 9.2 kg. So to find 140%, all I need to do, I can express 140 as a fraction of 100 and I multiply with 9.2 kg. And this will give me 12.88 kg. Some of you might be wondering, how come I can just do it like directly in this manner? Okay, so let me show you some workings. Okay, so let's say if we do a longer method, here I will write down 100%. It's 9.2 kg. And after that, I'll find out what is 1%, which is 9.2 over 100. After that, to find out what is 140%, I'll take 9.2 over 100, multiply with 140. And this will give me 12.88. kg. So if you notice, right, this expression here is actually the same as 140 over 100 times 9.2. Why? Because 9.2 times 140 over 100 is the same as writing the one on the left hand side. So these are the same statement. So that's why I can just take 140 over 100 times 9.2. Okay, so let's look at the next one. Now I need to find out 22.8% of $45. So I express 22.8 as a fraction and multiply by 45. So you must be wondering, how come I choose 100 as a base? Because I know that $45 represents 100%. So that's why I express it over 100%. So in this case, it will be 22.8 divided by 100 times 45, which is $10.26. Okay, so let's say, instead of giving you 100%, I tell you that 10% of a number, it's $5. This is an example. Am I able to apply such method to find out what is 100%? Also can. So if you want to find 100%, I can take 100 over 10 times $5. So the percentage at the bottom will always be equivalent to the quantity that is representing. And the number above, this one here, it'll be depending on what percentage that I want to find. So if I want to find 100%, I put here as 100. If I want to find 20%, put there as 20. When I work it out, it'll be $50. So you must be wondering, why does this work? Why? Because when I want to find 10% from, so when I want to find 100% from 10%, I'm actually multiplying by 10. I'm trying to find out what is 10 times the amount of 10%, which is 100%. So if you have noticed, it's the same as writing 10 times $5. So by expressing the percentage in the form of a fraction, you can find out how many times you need to find out a particular quantity. So for this case, in order to find out what is 100%, I need to find out what is 10 times the amount of 10%, which is 100%. So in this case, I take 10 times $5. So this one here, it tells us the proportion, how many times we need to find out a particular quantity we want. Okay, so I hope this clarifies some of your doubt. So if you are still unsure, you can always drop me a text. I will go through with you personally. Okay, so for the rest of the questions, please try to do your review yourself. If you are still unsure what is it about, please ask. Because if you don't ask, when school reopens, you'll be proceeding with chapter 8 already. Okay, so for question 8, right? It is just a bonus question. It's just for some of you who want to challenge yourself, you can just try it out. So there are many possible answers. So for example, 130 adults and 70 children also fit the criteria of 65% of them are adults, 35% of them are children. So there are multiple answers for this question 8. As long as the number of people that you have found, all of them must be integer, that means whole number. Okay, so for question 9. Okay, so for question 9, what does it mean, right? To express the first quantity as a percentage of the second quantity. So that means you're using the first value as the numerator, that means the number at the top of the fraction, and the bottom value as the denominator. That means the bottom value of the fractions. So first thing, I noticed that their units are not the same. So I have to convert them to the same unit. So 4 meter, to convert it to cm, centimeter, I need to times 100. So it's 400 cm. So I want to express the first quantity, which is 8 cm, as a percentage of the second quantity, which is 400. And I want to express it as a percentage. So I express them as a fraction first, then I find out what is the percentage. So in this case, it will be 8 over 400. In this case, it will be 2%. So for the rest, this one will be 10,000%. Why? Because this time round, I'm using a bigger number over a smaller number. So be expected to see that the percentage will be much higher than 100%. So let me work out the rest for you, then check your answers.